honor to be with you today. I'm very happy to come back to Malawi for a second time and to learn from the standing up comedy, the poetry, and the new language which I'm trying to understand, alhamdulillah. But I'm very happy. Ramadan Kareem, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the first 10 days was Rahmah, second is Maghfirah, and third is Idhum al-Nar. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
Since you are a businessman and dealing with business, I have the Arabic word of a businessman, which is Tajir. Tajir, Te, Alif, Jim Ra. Te stands for Taqwa. This is your character. Alif stands for Amana. Jim stands for Jur'a, taking risk. Reh stands for Ra, stands for Raja'. If he does a mistake or she does a mistake, go back and say, I'm sorry. This is the criteria of the businessman. Taqwa, Amana, risk taking, and go back to correct our mistakes. Clear? What we need to do, businessman, the definition for professional, because some of you call themselves professionals. Professional for me is the one who keep the time right. The one who deliver as he promised. The one who actually does not lie. It is not the character of professional, does not deceive. Professional for me is Iman. Professionalism is Iman. The Iman in the heart will be reflected in your business. One of the best and top businessmen and richest and wealthiest Muslim was Abdurrahman ibn Auf. Abdurrahman ibn Auf, when he came, immigrated from Mecca to Medina, okay, there was Prophet was trying to make brotherhood between the Ansar and Muhajirin. And he was asking to go to one of the Ansar houses, maybe share the wealth. He said, No, I'm a businessman. Guide me for the market. And he went to the market to make the business. And he became the wealthiest. And he used to say, whenever I donate 1,000, Allah give me 2,000. 2,000, 10,000. So he was sharing his wealth with the community. After the Prophet ﷺ died, he was looking after the Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, all of them, looking after them, spending his money on them. One day, the Medina went upside down. A lot of dust is coming out, and big caravan, 700 naqa, she camel, loaded with the goods from Sham, which is Syria. 740-foot container. By the time we calculate them now, and the 40-foot container, the truck, is owned by him, as well as the person. And Hazrat Aisha was looking, what's going on in Medina? They said, this is the caravan of Abdurrahman ibn Auf. She said to the one who was telling her that, I have heard the Prophet ﷺ saying that Abdurrahman ibn Auf will go to heaven crawling, not walking, not running. That brother, because he loved Abdurrahman ibn Auf, he kept flying to tell him, I have heard the Umm al-Mu'min Aisha saying that you go to heaven crawling. He ran back to Umm al-Mu'min Aisha and telling her, please, what the Prophet said about me. She told him the hadith. And he said, with the name of Allah, I give all the 700 she camel with the loads to the people of Medina. to the people of Allah, so Allah might change my condition when I go to heaven, inshallah. You can calculate the 700 she coming, or the 740 foot container or ships coming to Malawi at one time with the current, with the current calculation, how many millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars be? Just like that. When he died, he did not die as a poor man. He used to get the gold and cut it, the blocks of gold and cut it, and the land, and the silver, and the, all the wealth that he left, in spite of the fact he gave, kept giving. Because when he was giving to Allah, Allah was giving him more and more and more and more. Because Allah is Al-Kareem, the generous. Allah is the giver. Allah is the provider. Allah is the sustainer. Allah is the supporter. Allah is the one who gives rizq. You cannot stand and tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I feed your people, without him feeding you, your family, your people, and the whole barakah come back to you.
Takbir! Allah!
This is the character of Abdul Rahman Nawaf, should be in us. In us. In us. How to build our community. Second point, if we are businessmen, we need to have like coordination, cooperation. See, we shouldn't work in isolation. And each one of us should learn from his brother and his sister doing the business. And you might have a commercial, what do you call it? Commercial, what do you call it? Chamber of Commerce. Do you have Chamber of Commerce yourself?
Yes, you
have. How many members?
I think it's open for those who are doing SMEs and the private sector, yes.
How much? How many?
I don't know.
Well, you have this. The most important thing of the Chamber of Commerce is to exchange the news and the experience. And maybe you start having your own bank in the future. You don't have it yet. To invest in the community. To invest in the community, to invest in the community. And believe me, brothers and sisters, Malawi is a rich country.
Takbir! Allah!
Malawi is a rich country. Malawi, whoever, I was giving a talk for you last year, whoever, because somebody was saying that a country X is a very poor and the people are very poor. I said in my talk, whoever say that, he is degrading Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A'udhu billahi min shaitanir rajim. Why? Because Allah, when he created the land, he knows in his knowledge that how many millions of people will be living on the surface of this land after 1,000 or 2,000 or 3,000 years. And the wealth underneath your feet and our feet, it will be more than the 100 million people will be living on the land. Don't ever come and tell me that Allah has created me as a human being, then he put me on this piece of land to become poor. Poverty comes from myself, because I don't do much. But from myself, because I don't believe in myself and my country and the risk that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From myself, because I'm a corrupt man or a corrupt woman. From myself, because I cut corners. Okay? And I stab this and this and this and this. From myself, because I steal the resources from my brothers and my sisters. But my land is extremely rich. And I have to discover everything in my land and have the power and the energy of using it, utilizing it, sharing it with others. Don't come and tell me that the weather is very hard on me because it's sun. Is that right? Very hot, isn't it? The Sahaba, when they walked to Malawi, they walked, did not use the plane, they did use the cars, they did not use the ship. There'd be some boats to come here. When the Sahaba walk to China, if you go to China, there are mosques from the Sahaba time. They walked. Did they reach in there? On their food, maybe by using the donkey, using camels, in the middle of the desert. When the young people who used to come to learn Islam from Andalusia, from Spain, to come in Iraq, they used to walk the whole distance because they wanted, they have the iman that they want to learn from Imam Abu Hanbal, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, radiallahu anhu, or Abu Hanifa, radiallahu anhu. They used to walk. Spain, Morocco, Algeria, Tunisia, Libya, Egypt, then cross to Iraq to learn. Took them a year or two to learn for a few hadith. This is the drive which makes you rich. The belief that actually you want to become a good businessman to help your family, to help your community, and to be a good slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Takbir!
So connection and the coordination is a must. And partnership is a must. And I come back to what I mentioned earlier, is tajir, is taqwa, amana, jur'a, which is risk taking, and admitting that he is has done something wrong. When Hazrat Uthman radiallahu anhu, he had another caravan coming to Medina at the time when you know all these stories. And the people there wanted to buy it from him for the whole price. He said, I got somebody. They actually twice as much said, I got somebody. 10 times. He said, oh, no, Uthman. Well, all the businessmen of Medina here. Who is this? He says, Allah. Allah is the one I'm going to give my caravan to. And they give the whole caravan to the Prophet and to the Muslims. Never underestimate how your business will be protected by how much you can give to the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I thank you very much, brothers and sisters, for letting me to speak with you. And I thank Allah for letting me to come and be with you today. And I hope that you'll be very prosperous, very rich, like Abdurrahman ibn Awf, like Hazrat Uthman, like all the people who put business and iman in their hearts, so the iman was driving their business and their community. JazakAllah khair, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.